A Philippine congressional panel cites in contempt two hosts of the Sunshine Media Network International for refusing to properly answer its questions. The details from Vivian Gulia.
A heated discussion ensued during Tuesday's resumption of the congressional inquiry into allegations of fake news peddling against broadcast network Sunshine Media Network International after SMNI anchor Jeffrey K. Eric Celis requested the House Committee on Legislative Franchises to strike from its records the statements he issued last hearing, citing the absence of a competent legal counsel. Celis previously admitted his claim on House Speaker Martin Romualdez's 1.8 billion peso travel expenses was erroneous.
I believe my constitutional rights were violated.
Mr. Chairman, the answer and manifestation of Mr. Celis is out of order. He is out of order because you cannot dictate in this house and you cannot move. Only members of the you ask members of this house. Do not lecture us.
No,
about
I am not
the
lecturing.
Of this
I am standing up for my right.
Mr.
I am standing up for my right.
Remember, we might cite you in contempt.
Then so be it. Your Honor.
You challenge us?
Yes.
Okay.
If that will be sin in the nation, na walang karapatan ang mga invited guests dito na magpahayag.
Out of order is all about your manifestation to strike on up. Patapusin mo ako.
The Honorable.
Huwag ka maimbastos. Patapusin mo ako. I am not stopping him to issue statement. What I'm saying is, and what I'm pointing out over there is the manifestation.
No one is curtailing your right. In fact, kaya ka nga nandito, binibigyan ka ng panahon, ng oras para magsalita. But do not play to the crowd saying that your rights are violated in this committee. It's not.
Quezon 2nd District Representative J.J. Suarez repeatedly asked Celis to name his source, but he refused. Celis cited the Soto Law, which protects accredited journalists from being compelled to reveal the source of a news report or information unless such revelation is demanded by the security of the state. The committee chairperson refused to accept Celis' assertion, prompting Surigao del Sur 2nd District Representative Johnny Pimentel to move for citing the SMNI anchor in contempt. The panel approved the motion.
Mr. Celis has already violated two provisions of Section 11. The first one, acting in a disrespectful manner, and the second one, which is very more important rather, is his refusal to answer the question in a relevant inquiry. On this note, Mr. Chair, I move to contempt, to cite for contempt Mr. Celis for on these two grounds under Section 11. So move, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion. Thank you for this kind of court.
The panel also cited SMNI host and former anti-communist task force spokesperson Lorraine Badoy in contempt for failing to accurately answer questions regarding advertisers.
Please remain from lying kasi we will be citing you for contempt. Kasi nakalagay po sa revenue, submitted nyo, nakita na binabanggit nyo kanina na meron kayong kinita na dineklara nyo rin dito. In other words, you are lying.
Contempt, refusal to answer in a relevant inquiry, acting in a disrespectful manner because she was found lying, Mr. Chair. That would be my reason to declare, to make a motion to declare her in contempt.
And I'm deeply saddened by what I've seen today. Now, but I respect the committee because this is how I was brought up by my father, to be honorable. And to have my fullest trust pa rin in the institution, hindi natitinag yan, Mr.
Both Celis and Badoy will be detained at the House of Representatives until the committee report is adopted at the plenary. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.